Hey guys, Max from Combo, and today we are taking a look at the just announced OnePlus Nord CE 2 Lite. This is a cheaper version of the Nord CE 2 from OnePlus. So don't expect too much in terms of high-end flagship features here, but there's certainly a few features to take note of, and it currently stands as one of the cheaper 5G phone options that you can buy. So let's have a look, see what you get in the box. So inside here we have some, so there's an included case, kind of just a clear plastic, pretty standard case as you tend to get with OnePlus phones. And in here we've just got some paperwork and a SIM ejector tool, nothing too interesting there. And then here we have the phone itself. So as I mentioned, this kind of sits right at the bottom of OnePlus's current lineup. So the Nord itself is a cheaper series than the higher end kind of OnePlus 10 series. So this is the cheapest version in that line of phones, basically. So yeah, don't expect too many super high-end features. This is in the dusk colorway, so it's kind of super black on the bottom, and then you've got a kind of textured finish at the top with kind of a glossy look. Let's just peel this little sticker off the bottom. There we go, there's the phone itself. As you can see, there's a dual camera array on the top. There's a flash. Actually, there's three cameras. So you've got two main cameras and then kind of a tertiary sensor there. There's a flash as well. Some minor OnePlus branding there. On the bottom, we have a USB-C port for charging. This can charge at 33 watts. And there's a headphone jack as well. And then not much on the top. Again, sides fairly basic. You've got a power button on the one side and a volume rocker on the other side. Interestingly, the one of OnePlus's kind of features that we like to see on its higher end phones is the quick toggle for moving between vibration silent mode. I'm not a massive fan that they've removed it on these cheaper phones. It would have been nice to kind of keep that OnePlus DNA that we've got used to, even on the kind of more budget options, but here that's nowhere to be found. So as you can kind of probably tell from the slightly large box, there is more in here than you might get with some other devices. Here we've got the charger and the classic OnePlus red charging USB-C cable. This is a USB-A to USB-C. As you can kind of see, there's a USB-A port there. Kind of one of the features OnePlus is touting with this phone is the fast charging. So while it won't charge quite as quickly as the pricier phones, even the pricier Nord 2T, there is still 33 watt charging included. So I mean, that's faster than you get with a Pixel phone or an iPhone. So again, that's really nice to see. In terms of specs for the device itself, this is a 5G device, which is always nice to see, especially at this low price point. It has a 120Hz LCD display measuring 6.59 inches. So while it's not an OLED display like some of the pricier Nord devices, this does have the benefit of having 120Hz refresh rate, so it should be super smooth for scrolling through Instagram and be a bit more responsive during gaming. OnePlus also said that the screen can dynamically refresh. They weren't too specific about exactly how dynamic that can be. I believe it's kind of can jump between 30, 60 and 120. So again, that's there for saving battery life and those kind of things. Inside, you've got 6 GB of RAM. There's 128 GB of storage. There's a micro SD expansion as well, which is something you wouldn't find on the pricier OnePlus phone. So that's nice to see that here. There's also a 5000 mAh battery inside. And on the back, you've got a 64 megapixel main camera and a 2 MP depth camera. You know, first impressions are this kind of feels like a fairly basic device. It'll retail for £279, which considering the specs on offer, you know, the 5G, the 1080p, 120Hz display, certainly nothing to be sniffed at. But as with all these cheap OnePlus phones, it doesn't necessarily feel much like a OnePlus phone that we've kind of got used to. OnePlus kind of prided itself a lot on kind of going that extra mile in the phones that it produced, and I've always found these cheaper Nord devices kind of miss that point slightly. The profile switcher, again, is kind of one of those reasons why this doesn't necessarily feel too much like a OnePlus phone. Somewhere where it does feel like a OnePlus phone is in the software. As you can see, this has this very typical OnePlus look with the shelf for your widgets and stuff. And OnePlus says you'll also get two full Android updates and an extra year of security patches. So again, for a cheap phone, that's always nice to see. We've actually seen some more higher end flagship phones only promise 2 years of Android updates. So again, props to OnePlus for promising that, and hopefully they deliver on those promises kind of further down the phone's lifespan. So that's just a quick first look at the OnePlus Nord CE2 Lite. This will retail for £279 in the UK. Let me know what you think of the phone below, and we'll hopefully be back with a full review.